गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो वेलकम टू क्लास अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. द टॉपिक टुडेस टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. ओके चिल्ड्रन, सो यू ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इन लोअर क्लासेस इन एथ क्लासेस. सो फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. इलेक्ट्रिसिटी व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी? इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इट इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स which deals with the electric charges. So again, electricity is classified into two branches, static electricity and current electricity. So static electricity means it is a branch of electricity which deals with the electric charges which are at rest. Okay, so that is static electricity. And other branch of electricity which deals with the electric charges which are in motion. So whenever the charges, electric charges are set into motion, you know, electric charges, there are two types of electric charges are there, positive and negative. So whenever these electric charges, they are set into motion, okay, so that branch of electricity which deals with these charges which are in motion, so that is called as a current electricity. So our today topic is about current electricity or electric current. Okay children. So electric current, first let me define what is electric current. Okay, you can see here, number one, first point, what it is? Electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charge. What it is? Electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charge. So whenever electric charge is flowing across any conducting material, so it is called as a electric current. So always, whether the flow of charges always they constitute electric current? No. Okay, what kind of flow of charges constitute electric current? So that is second point. If you look at the second point, so ordered motion of charges constitute an electric current. Okay, ordered motion of charges means all the charges, they move along the same direction. So if you see in the figure here, okay children, so in the figure there are negative charges, they are moving in the through the across the circuit in the same direction. So in clockwise direction, they are moving in clockwise direction. So in the circuit we can see an electric bulb is there, connecting wire is there, and a battery is there. Okay, so here all the negative charges, electrons, they are moving in a clockwise, anti-clockwise direction, not clockwise, anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so they are all moving in the same direction, that is ordered motion. So whenever there is an ordered motion of charges, then only they constitute electric current. So number three, so when these ordered motion of charges is possible, so if you look at third point, so when a conductor is connected to a battery, an electric field is developed across the conductor which makes an ordered motion of charges. Important one. Okay, if there is no battery is connected to the wires, the bulb does not glow. Why? There is no more electric current. So whenever a battery is connected to the wire, okay, so then immediately the bulb glows. What is the reason? So here the battery, it develops an electric field across the conductor, and that electric field makes all the charges, here the electrons are the charges, negative charges, they are all moving in the same direction, that is anti-clockwise direction. So then it leads to electric current, so that the bulb is glowing. Okay children, so what is electric current? Electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charge. So the ordered motion of charges constitute an electric current. So when a conductor is connected to a battery, an electric field is developed across the conductor which makes an ordered motion of charges. So now come to the point here, if I is a current through the conductor, okay, I amount of current is passing through the conductor or circuit, and capital Q is a charge flowing through the conductor, the total charge flowing through the conductor is, if it is capital Q, and T is a time interval, okay, in this time that charge, okay, Q charge is flowing through the conductor. If we take any cross section of a conductor, so to cross that cross section of the conductor, T is the time interval. So then current is defined as, so how it is defined? It is a ratio of electric charge to time interval. So I is equal to Q by T. So electric current is equal to electric charge divided by time interval. So this is a formula for the electric current. So now SI unit of current, it is ampere. What is the SI unit of electric current? Ampere. Okay, children. So 1 ampere is defined as, 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb by 1 second. So 1 coulomb is the SI unit of electric charge and 1 second is the SI unit of time. So 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb by 1 second, children. So let us move to the next slide. Okay, children, you can see this next slide. In the next slide, what it is? Ordered motion of charges. Okay. You see here. If all the charges move along the same direction, such motion is a ordered motion, which is the, which occurs when a conductor is connected to a battery. So the ordered motion of charges constitute electric current. So in the figure, we can see in the figure. Okay. So here, all the electrons, they are moving towards the positive terminal of the battery. Okay, and they are starting from the negative terminal of the battery. Remember, children. So whenever there is ordered motion of charges is there, then only there exists an electric current in the circuit. Okay, children. Next, let us move to the next slide. Disordered motion of charges. If all the charges through the conductor do not move in the same direction, such motion is called disordered motion, which does not constitute any current in the conductor. So this is the case when the conductor is not connected to a battery. So if you look at the diagram here, the how the electrons they are moving randomly. Okay, they are moving, okay, in any arbitrary direction. They are not moving in a same direction. So such kind of motion is called disordered motion. Okay, children. So disordered motion of charges, it does not constitute any electric current. So next, drift velocity. Okay, children, what is this drift velocity? So here, the velocity with which all the charges move with a constant velocity when a conductor is connected to a battery is called a drift velocity. So when a conductor is connected to a battery, what is happening? All the electrons are moving in the same direction. So how they move? They move with a constant velocity or they move with any acceleration. Okay, that is important point has to be cleared here. So here, all the electrons in the conductor, so when the conductor is connected to the battery, they all move with a constant velocity. So that is a uniform motion of electrons can be witnessed. Okay, so all the electrons through the conductor, they move with a constant velocity. That constant velocity is called as a drift velocity. It is denoted by Vd. Okay, what is drift velocity? The velocity with which all the electrons move with a constant velocity when a conductor is connected to a battery is called a drift velocity. So next point, due to the continuous resistance offered to the flow of electrons, charges or electrons by the ionic lattice of the conductor, there exists uniform motion of charges or electrons instead of accelerated motion. So why these electrons, they move with a constant velocity across the conductor when it is connected to a battery? So while they are moving through a conductor, continuously they experience a resistance. A resistance is offered to those electrons. Okay, similarly when a vehicle is moving on a road, okay, so which is provided with continuous speed breakers. So what happens to that vehicle? Okay, that vehicle has to move with a constant velocity. In similar way here also. when the electrons are moving across the conductor, okay, when it is connected to your battery, okay. So all the electrons, they move with a constant velocity. Why? Because there is a resistance is offered continuously to the flow of these electrons, so that those all electrons move with a constant velocity. Okay, that constant velocity is defined as a drift velocity. Okay, it is not an accelerated motion, it is a uniform motion of electrons. Okay, so here next I is equal to q by t, we have already seen. So here that is okay. Right, so here what is the relation between drift velocity and current? So we already seen current, electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charge, I is equal to q by t, which is equal to n into q into a into vd into t by t. So in the diagram, if you look at the picture here, so what is a? It is the area of cross section of the conductor. Small n, the number of charges per unit volume of the conductor, and VD, that is the average velocity of the electrons, and small q is the charge on each electron, okay, or charge. Okay, so that is the relation between electric current and drift velocity is written as I is equal to N into Q into A into VD, and which can be written as VD is equal to I by N Q A. Okay, so what is the formula for the drift velocity? So drift velocity VD is equal to I by N Q A. So here I means electric current in the circuit, small n is the number of charges per unit volume. So charges means electrons, if it is a conductor, metallic conductor, electrons are the charges. Okay, small n is the number of electrons per unit volume of the conductor, whereas small q, it is the charge on each, magnitude of charge on each charge carrier. Okay, and capital A is the area of cross section. So this is important formula examination point of view. So drift velocity is equal to VD is equal to I by N Q A. Okay children, so hope you understood. Okay, so let us end this session or class. Okay, children, thank you.